In this brief video, we will look at the government's ability to directly provide certain goods and services. We will see the impact of this provision on the market. Once we understand why the government provides goods and services, we can examine how they do it. Firstly, certain goods such as education are likely to be underprovided by the private sector. The government would intervene to increase their production to move towards the socially optimal level of output. The positive externalities of education are many, and it is in the government and society's interest to have an educated populace. The trade-off of government intervention and expenditure is the opportunity cost. When the government spends more on education, they may have to spend less elsewhere, such as healthcare or defense. Students should be aware of the reasons why the government should provide goods and services and the arguments against. You are able to support this analysis with an understanding of merit goods and public goods. There is a video in Unit 1 to review this. However, the argument against is influenced by the fact that the government will not face competition if they are directly providing goods and services. In providing a system of defense, there is no competing industry or defense agency. This may result in inefficiency due to a lack of incentive in reducing costs. It is also important to understand that the government may choose to pay private sector firms to provide goods and services as opposed to taking on the work themselves. This could result in lowered costs as businesses compete for contracts, but it is no guarantee. Thanks again for watching. Please leave any questions or comments below. Email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com or tweet me at enhancedtuition. I'll see you in the next one.